I listen to Psalm 103, it doesn't matter whether I have it or not. It doesn't matter whether I'm happy or not, whether I sing it or not. I need to force myself to praise the Lord. He says, bless the Lord, Psalm 103:1. He says, bless the Lord, all my soul. Bless his holy name. So he's saying, bless the Lord. So we see here that he maintained his focus, amen, by giving glory to God. So let's read Habakkuk chapter 3. Habakkuk 3:17, and it says that though the fig tree does not bud, and though there is no fruit on the vines, though the olive crop fails, and the fields produce no food, though there are no sheep in the pen, and there are no cattle in the stalls, amen. He says, yet, amen. Somebody says, yet.
Yes.
Yet. Let us read verse 18, everyone together, up to 19. He says, yet I will triumph in the Lord. I will rejoice in the God of my salvation. Yahweh, my Lord, is my strength. He makes my feet like those of a deer, and he enables me to walk on mountain heights. Hallelujah. So he says it doesn't matter whether the fig tree is a very reproductive tree, and it produces so many things, and we get olives from it. We use different things with the olive oil. People say multi things that we use. But he says that even though the fig tree, whether it produces fruit or not, hallelujah, even if it doesn't produce any crop, even if the fruit fields, they've got no field, amen, even if there's no sheep in the pen, hallelujah, if there's no cattle in the state, he says, yet I'll triumph in the Lord. So he maintained his focus by giving glory to God. Let us maintain our focus by giving glory to God. Whenever we lose our focus, that, you know what, I'll still triumph in the Lord. It doesn't matter that my situation is dead, for me I shall triumph in the Lord. Although my situation looks like there's no life in it, for me I'll rejoice in the God of my salvation, because it is him that gives life. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter how my situation looks like, but for me the Lord is my strength. He shall strengthen me in faith, he shall strengthen my unbelief, he shall strengthen my body. Hallelujah. It says it shall make me like the feet like those of a deer, and also enables me to walk on mountain height. So God will still continue to cause me to excel. Hallelujah. He shall still cause me to be successful. He shall still cause me to prosper. But at the end of the day, my focus, hallelujah, my focus has to be stayed upon the Lord Jesus Christ. So if we are going to walk in the supernatural, maintain our focus by giving glory to God. That God, I know, could the doctor's report, that the doctor's report has said that I don't have enough time to live, or that this situation is incurable, or maybe the doctors have said I cannot make it, or maybe even in my company they don't want to move me forward. But as for me, I will triumph in God. Hallelujah. As for me, I will triumph. So no matter how dead the situation is, we should need to maintain our focus by giving glory to God. Let us rejoice in the Lord always. Let us just speak to ourselves when we wake up in the morning. No matter how we feel, it doesn't matter how we feel, whether we are low, whether we are down, whether we are angry, whether we are hatred, whether we go, whatever. But let's just say to ourselves that, you know what, my soul, today this is the day that the Lord has made. Therefore, bless the Lord, O my soul, and bless his holy name. It doesn't matter what I see or what I hear, but as for me, I will triumph in the Lord. Therefore, bless the Lord, O my soul. Hallelujah. So we taught here in James that be doers and be doers of the word. Let us not just be hearers, because we deceive ourselves. Hallelujah. Why is he saying that? Because he knows that the word of God produces results. Hallelujah. The word of God produces results. So we don't, if we do not stay in the word, then we don't expect results. Amen. We don't expect any results. So God's word won't produce any results except we do what, like what Abraham did. We act on what we hear. Hallelujah. We need to act on what we hear. The Bible talks about it, I think in Acts 19, when the church in Berea, that whenever they went home, even as we are taught here in church, don't just go back and put your Bible down and say, oh, because Pastor Beata has spoken, that's why she says the scriptures. You need was right. Hallelujah. So let us act on the on what we hear. Hallelujah. And then apart from that, let us also create the right environment for faith to work, for faith to move. He says that he maintained his focus by giving glory to God. So he was praising God. So create an environment of praise. Create an environment of faith. Hallelujah. In order for him to work, you need the correct environment. Not the environment of unbelief. Not the environment, like he says here, that he did not waver through unbelief. Not that of being weak. Hallelujah. So we need to maintain a good environment in order for him to work. Secondly, we need to believe the word of God. And he said to Thomas, he says that blessed are those, amen, who believe without seeing. Because they shall receive that which they believe in. Hallelujah. They shall get that which they are believing for. So we need to believe the word of God. It's only the word of God that brings life. He says his word is truth and it brings life to us. So if you do not believe the word, what will you believe? Because if you do not believe the word and something comes your way, then you go on the wayside. Hallelujah. But we need to believe in the word of God. And apart from that, we need to act on the word like Abraham did. He acted upon the word of God. So we'll be looking today at the qualities. So I just want to mention in closing, as we have looked at the qualities of prevailing faith, so I wanted to mention four qualities of prevailing faith. Firstly, it does not consider our physical circumstance. The Bible says, did not look at his body, or neither the body of Sarah, that it was dead. So it does not consider physical circumstances. Hallelujah. The second thing, it does not stagger. So it's not wishful, it is focused. You have to believe it. If you want it to come to pass, you have to believe it. And when you believe it, you stand on your word. Hallelujah. No matter what anybody or anything says, you have to stand on your word. Then apart from that, it gives glory to God. Whatever God does, it is for his glory. Amen. Whatever God does is for his glory. The promises of God are for his glory. Even the life that you are living today is for the glory of God. That's why we surrender our lives to God. Hallelujah. Because our lives are not our own. Our lives belong to God. So whatever the prevailing, the point of prevailing faith is that it gives glory to God. The glory of God is seen through it. And you're able to testify that if this was not for God, that's why God refused that. No, it is not Ishmael. It's not Ishmael. Because anybody can produce an Ishmael. Hallelujah. Anybody can produce an Ishmael. But not everybody can produce an Isaac. Hallelujah. Need to produce an Isaac to give glory to God. They tried the shortcut. The shortcut worked, but it brought consequences to them. Hallelujah. And apart from that, the fourth quality is that it is usually persuaded. Hallelujah. God said that he was convinced in him. What kept Abraham going is that he was convinced that it is God who gives life. And because God is able to give life, I shall trust this God. So it was persuaded. So what is the persuasion that you have in you this year? If you are going to work in the supernatural, we need to be persuaded that life comes from God and that God never turns back on his word. He says that the word that I release from my mouth in Isaiah chapter 55 is from 9 to 11. He says that the word that I release from my mouth, since I'm not back to me void, but it shall accomplish the purpose that it has been sent for. Hallelujah. So in closing, let's just rise to our feet. I want to say to each and every one of us, let's start speaking forth good things. Amen. If we want to see things, if we want to make things happen in our life this year, let us start speaking forth the word of God. Let us speak forth the mind of God, the purposes and the promises of God. Let us be persuaded that it is life to our situation, that it is God who is able to give life. Let us trust in God. Let us not waver. And this year, I want us to pray that God, what is your promise for me this year? That God will reveal his promise for you, his promise for your children, his promise for your family, his promise, hallelujah, even for the ministry. Because that is what you're going to hold on to. In order for you to hold on, you need a word from God. Because if you do not have a word from God, you will stagger. Amen. If you do not time you have a word from God, you'll be unwavering. You move from side to side. So you need a word from God. Amen. Let's just raise up our feet to our hands to the Lord. Even in close prayer, we just pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to thank you for your word. Father, we want to thank you, Jehovah God, for the qualities that you have given us. Father, we pray that you shall be able to move in these qualities of faith in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, may we be strengthened by faith. May each and every one of us help and be convicted, Jehovah God. Father, I pray for each and every one of us that we shall not consider our physical situation. That Father, help us not to stagger. Help us, Jehovah God, to give glory to you in all things, Jehovah God. Father, I pray for that persuasion to walk according to your word. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Therefore, we pray, Jehovah God, in this day, that we shall prevail in faith, Jehovah God. In Jesus' mighty name, we give you praise and glory, and we give you honor. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah. Let's just give glory to God. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm just going to move to Pastor to come and do the Holy Communion. Hallelujah.
What's the problem?
The bread stands for the body of
Jesus Christ. And the blood stands for the blood of Jesus. The wine stands for the blood of Jesus Christ. He told them to say, take the bread. It is food indeed. Take the blood. It is drink indeed. If the emblems, the bread, stands for the body of Jesus Christ, then when we partake of it, it will give us strength, it will give us energy. If we drink the drink with the blood of Jesus, it will vitalize our bodies, it will heal every disease. Let's just pray. Father in heaven, as we partake of this emblems at the beginning of this year, we are believing you as we heard from the word. By faith, we are taking this Holy Communion. We believe that the body of Jesus Christ, which was struck and put on the cross, was put there for the remission of sin. We pray that as we partake of these emblems, heal every disease in our bodies. Heal every situation in the mighty name, the name of Jesus Christ. Please just come forward as we partake of these emblems and get the bread and the wine as we partake of these emblems. Please, if you come forward, let's take the bread and the wine as we partake of these emblems. Get the drink and the bread, and then you stand there, take the bread and the drink, and then you hold it, and then we will sit together as we partake of this. Take the bread and the drink, and then you stand here, Eliza, the right man.
One of us.